Hello everybody, ZombieGuts here, and welcome back to Resident Evil 7. Now I think we're getting pretty close to the end of this game. Or at least I hope so. And I would like to try to finish this game in the episode, so hopefully we can do that. Did I miss anything in this room? Hey, corrosive. I'm glad I came back and checked. Because I actually need that. Let's see. Open the door with the corrosive. Find a power cable on the third floor sick bay. I believe this door needed a corrosive. So let's zoom that up and head in here and see what's going on. Nothing. Strong chem fluid. Captain's locker key. That's really useful. I hope. Lots more remote bombs. Looks like nothing else. So, now that we have the captain's locker cabin key, we can head up to the fourth floor and unlock the captain's cabin locker, get the machine gun, and hopefully some more corrosives, because we're gonna need some. I maybe should have saved that for the third floor, but I imagine there's another one around somewhere. Up the world's longest ladder, and let's see how it goes. There's a lot of enemies in the ship now, and I don't like it. Especially those four-legged ones. The quadruped guys will straight wreck your day. It's horrifying how strong they are. Is he dead? I think he's dead. Yep. I did not even mean to shoot there, but it happened. I have lots of remote bombs, so I should probably start making use of this. I hear enemies. Come on, buddy. A little bit closer, a little bit closer. There you can go. I believe that just straight up killed him. Yep. Alright, let's use this key. Grab some good stuff. More bombs. But we have a machine gun now, which, man, with lots of ammo, so that's good. Don't see any more corrosives in here, which is unfortunate. So third floor sick bay is where we're headed. We need corrosives. Not entirely sure where to find one. So I guess we just go looking. Hey, bobblehead guy. I probably should have saved the corrosive for this third floor door. Unfortunately, I'm not entirely sure where another one is. Anything in here? Nope. So I guess now I'm gonna head back down to the third floor and see if I can find anything up there. Or down there, I guess. I don't think there's anything up here that I missed, but just in case. There's this box. Oh yeah, I opened that box. Had an antique coin in it. Nothing useful at all. I wish I had kept that corrosive so I could use that door, because I believe that door leads to the sick bay. But it's a bit late for that, I suppose. You know, we just gotta make do with what we got. So let's head down to second floor. I'm gonna see if I can find any more corrosives. God, I hear so many enemies everywhere. It's horrifying. I don't know where they actually are, or if they're above or below me. They sound so far away. Let's see if there's anything in here. Doesn't look like it. 16 years since the nightmare of Raccoon City, the survivors are still suffering. That's interesting. So that puts this game in the timeline somewhere. At least 16 years after the Raccoon City outbreak of the first game. That's interesting. Yeah, Resident Evil timeline is so wonky. It's all over the place. So someone who is more familiar with it will have to tell me exactly what that means, but that's still really interesting. It won't open. It's a puzzle. I see. There's got to be some kind of clue as to what's going on here then, right? Oh, wait a minute. It's supposed to mirror those? That's how they are currently. Still won't open. Oh, that's not how they are, actually. I had the blue on the bottom. It should be on the top. Still won't open. Okay. Won't actually let me take these off the walls. Oh, I can move this too. I see. Maybe that's the problem. Good lord. That was a horrifying noise. Okay, lots of corrosive. That's what we were looking for, boys. And girls. So, what's in here? Now we can go up to third floor again and do corrosive things. Nothing in there. Let's head back out of here. Hopefully not be attacked by lots of enemies. Gotta find the elevator again. So the third floor sick bay, and I believe what I need down here, this might be just, what is this? A fuse. So the general purpose fuse is the item that I had when I was on the first floor, and I used it to get into the stairwell, so maybe I have to go back and grab that. I was thinking it's possible, so I'll probably go do that after I get this wire. That's the word I'm looking for, wire. Running very low on inventory space though, unfortunately. Go in there. It's exceedingly dark in here. Am I near the sick bay? Yeah, I'm near the sick bay. Okay. Lots of horrifying goopy goo. Lots of chem fluid that I can't pick up. My mouse decided to freak out there for a moment. Oh god, is it a fatty? It's a fatty, isn't it? There you go. Oh Ow. Ow. Very acidic. Again, very acidic. Please stop getting so many oranges. Tropical fruits of any kind, really. Would advise against it if you have the acid reflux. Hit him with another remote bomb. I don't want to use all my machine gun ammo. There we go, he did. Well, that took way more stuff than I really wanted it to. Two bombs. There's, I got one of them back at least. Two bombs and most of my machine gun ammo. Some more corrosive. I thought it was a puzzle for a second, but it's just... showing me unscrewing this. Power cable. I need to get rid of some of this chem fluid. I wish, one of the minor complaints I have with this game is that chem fluid doesn't stack. Which, I mean, I guess some people would argue that's a good thing. Makes it harder to manage inventory. Gets kind of tedious sometimes, though. I'll make a couple first aids to clear some space. Pick up this extra chem fluid here. Why not make all of it? Oh, there was where the guy came from, I think. So what are the other objectives? Find the fuse. I believe I know where the fuse is. I think I gotta go downstairs and grab it again. Actually, I'm kinda damaged. I'll go ahead and use some goopy goo. Boop. Okay, and then down here, hopefully not going to be mauled by spider guys, because there were some down here last time I was here. I am not a fan of the quadrupeds. The machine gun makes pretty quick work of them, though, so I'm a fan. Are you still alive? There we go. All it took was the entirety of my machine gun ammo. Everything's cool. I maybe shouldn't have used that, but... too late now. Oh my god, I thought something was busting out of there on me. That was horrifying. There's another place for me to use corrosive. And goop that right up. Another backpack. Sick. So much space now. I do like that they give you a means of expanding your inventory throughout the game. Especially, they seem to specifically place it around places where you're going to be carrying more than you have been. When you need to carry items for story progression purposes or for puzzles. That's really cool. I like that. Okay, I believe we have both things we need to fix this. Power cable. Fuse. Yep, we fixed it right up. Now, S2 is where we're headed. I probably should have saved on the second floor there, it's where it opened. But this game has autosave, so hopefully...
waiting.
Oh my god, that's so creepy, please no. Game has autosave, so if I die, it won't really be a huge deal. I hear a goopy man. There you are. I was looking for you, buddy. He's dead. Remote bomb. Lots of these. I'll start using them. There we go. His head exploded. We're out of machine gun ammo almost, so I'm gonna just hold on to the rest. Kind of kill somebody. Except now it is. That's a lot. And even more remote bombs. Hope there's not like a maximum number of these I can carry in a stack. Okay, he's dead. One more shot, just to make sure. Okay. This is all stuff from that tape. Although it's much creepier this time around. This dude has a giant goopy arm, so I'm gonna put a couple remote bombs down and deal with him. Boom. Think he should be dead from that? Yep, he is. God, why another fat dude? Put those down, wait for him to trudge his way down the stairs. Stomp, stomp, vomit, stomp. Even that didn't kill him. Ow. There we go. It brought him to like 3 machine gun bullets would kill him. More machine gun ammo. Definitely giving me a liberal amount of resources here. Man, please stop making terrifying noises. It's like something bad is happening. Oh, hello, Eveline and Ethan. What do you need me to do? I don't want to kill him. You gonna let me kill him?
Ethan.
Hi, Dad.
Shh. I know. I'm not gonna hurt you. Hell, I never would have if I could have helped you.
What do you mean?
I'm no killer, son. Neither is Marguerite, nor my boy Lucas, or even Zoe here. That girl, Eveline. She did this.
What the hell is she? Now, what did she do to you?
She infected us with her gift. That's what she calls it. I found her near a busted out tank in the bayou. Everything changed after that.
So she infects you and then she takes control?
No. Not exactly, son. She forces her way into your mind, your soul. You can't fight back. You are connected to her, and you can't resist the urge to. Oh, you're a different person after that.
Just like me. So Mia sent me that message because of Eveline.
Listen, the girl just wants a family of her own. She's the key, all right? You find her, you stop her. Ethan, free my family. Please.
That's just incredibly sad, honestly. Like, that's just really sad.
Stay away from him.
Why? He doesn't love you. I can make him love you.
Don't hurt him.
Silly, I told you I'm not gonna hurt him.
Don't you dare.
So what? You're not my mom. Remember?
I can look around in here.
Mia, how?
There's no time. You have to get out of here and find her. Here, take this.
What? Wait, what are you doing?
Saving your life.
Thank you, I think.
I won't be able to resist for much longer.
No.
Now go kill that little bitch.
No. Mia! No!
Rip Mia. But that's really interesting, the whole thing where you're talking to Jack in his normal, not psychotic form.
Where the fuck are you?
Do I have anything? I've got a bottle of things that Mia gave me. Okay. Disappearing goop. Oh, it wrote something. It's all your fault. What do you mean? Because I didn't want to be your daddy? We're back out here into the bayou. I'm walking real slow, like. Crouch under this. I hear a helicopter. I see a helicopter. Help me, please. There's a little girl trying to kill everybody. It's interesting, she just wants a family of her own, is what Jack said. Lots of dead fish in here. Gross. She just wants a family of her own. Murdering everyone seems like a highly ineffective way of getting a family of her own. Oh god, something's gonna jump out at me soon, isn't it? Lots of weird sounds going on. I hope they give me my weapons back soon. Enhanced handgun. February 18th, 1892. There was a collapse in the Patterson mine. Tuan and Beckford are dead, and Huxley will never walk on his own again. Old man Stan was right. The ground there is too unstable. February 19th, 1892. Company's not going to send us any replacements. They want us to work double shifts instead. I can't wait to get back to the old country. That is an excessively old journal. Abercrombie Salt Mine, South Dulvey. Are they watching us from that helicopter?
Alpha 1, this is Bravo 1. Do you read?
This is, yes. Alpha 1. Report. Did you find anything?
A thorough search of the Baker property revealed zero survivors. Repeat, zero survivors.
Survivor.
We did find evidence of a skirmish.
Eveline?
Negative. However, we did find several encrypted messages from the Baker's son, Lucas, to an unknown third party. You can probably guess who that was.
That's just great. We've had reports in the abandoned mine south of the property. I'm gonna go have a look.
Roger that. We'll meet you at those coordinates.
If you encounter Eveline, orders are shoot to kill. Repeat, shoot to kill.
Okay. That's strange. You've taken Mia's things. I have 3 antique coins. And I have lots of other stuff that I need to get out of here. So, I think I'm gonna take my survival knife, or Mia's survival knife, because it seemed to be stronger than mine. Okay. We're gonna grab the good handgun, the M19 handgun. All of this handgun ammo. I never got to use the repair kit on the other shotgun. That's unfortunate. We'll just grab this one for now on the shotgun shells. And, what else? I guess I'll take the machine gun and any machine gun ammo that I had left over. Seems to be like a decent loadout. What's left here? Stabilizer. And I can buy the Magnum there, or I can buy these steroids. I'm gonna buy these steroids. Because I feel like the game's winding to a close and I want to be able to have as much power as possible for whatever the game's gonna throw at me. Alright. Let's go ahead and save. And descend into this mine and hopefully not die. Here we go. Oh, hi fellas. How are you doing? One pump. One pump. There you go. I am curious how good the other shotgun would have been. Oh, that guy didn't get one pump. There we go. Not sure it was worth the ammo to do that, but I wanted to see what's in these boxes. That was the most enemies I've ever seen at one time in this game, also. Lots of first aid here. Some strong chem fluid. Slap this button. My gross hand. What's interesting about that ham radio broadcast is they say encrypted messages to a third party. You can probably guess who that is. And then they say he's probably at the old salt mine, which makes me, like, it sounds like they know who Ethan is, which strikes me as odd. I wouldn't have thought they would know who Ethan is. It seems like there's something bigger at play there. Ow. Ow. Can you not? You attack so fast. Whoa. Oh, that hit me anyways. I thought I reacted in time, but I did not. I wish I had herb. Would he use a strong chem fluid there? Okay, so it looks like Lucas is still at large, leaving traps everywhere. Jesus Christ. How many of you are there? Seriously, we're still not dead. Ugh. Going through my ammo real quick here. I should have just shotgunned from the beginning. I used so much handgun and machine gun ammo there. Almost walked on that again. Hey, herb. Okay, I feel like there's... Woo! Almost walked into that one. I Thought those were little crosses from the ceiling for a second there, but they're not. Alright. This looks pretty final. Somewhere that I can't get back out of, that drop there. Okay, dead end. Maybe something hiding in this pipe, though. Better believe there is. I know your game, Resident Evil. Hiding stuff in pipes that are out of sight. Okay. I'm gonna ditch the knife in favor of some remote bombs, because I'm running low on ammo. And my mouse keeps doing this weird thing where it, like... Let me fix that real quick. Because I don't want it to get me killed. Something keeps getting caught in the laser, I'm pretty sure. It's still doing it. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, seems good now. Deal with that guy right out of the gate. Dude, please just die. How are you not dead? There we go. God, more of them? Really? Okay. Dealt with that. So low on ammo already, and I had so much to begin with. Hope they give me more soon. I need to push this cart so that it slams into that stuff. Dude, if you can push that, you are a monster. An absolute freak of nature. Okay. Ethan is really strong, is what I've learned. First we had Chris Redfield punching boulders, now we got Ethan pushing carts full of rock and salt. With his bare hands. Which I guess it's on a track, it probably wouldn't be as hard as I'm imagining it. I'm gonna switch to this thing. Shoot that, because I don't trust my ability to crouch under it. Is this trapped? Yep. This is a strange room. Bathtubs. Somebody growing some stanky danky here. Or using it for experiments or something. Okay. Sent Friday, January 16th, 2015, 12:42 a.m. Thanks to you guys, it's been about a week since my head's been clear and back to normal, and she still thinks she's got me. You guys really need to work on fixing that. Not only does she look like a little kid, but she's about as stupid as one, too. Mom and Dad are still totally under, though. I was wondering, is this whole family obsession something you guys programmed into her? Is this Lucas writing this? Friday, November 4th. Mia is still somewhere in between Evie La La Land and reality. She gets pretty violent, so I locked her up in a cell. Thought maybe Eveline would get mad since Mia's her favorite and all, but she doesn't seem to care. She actually goes and visits her sometimes. She thinks Mia's her mommy. Like I said, your bioweapon is not working at all, apparently. Evelyn's family obsession is getting out of hand. She's making everyone kidnap more and more off the street to add to her freak show of a family. Maybe she's getting tired of me and not coming around. Gotta clean up the mess whenever someone new comes along. By the way, Evie's looking sick or something. Her skin's getting all wrinkly and she's getting gray hairs. Is that supposed to happen? It's almost like she's getting old all of a sudden. Is Evie Grandma... Is Evie Grandma Has she been playing me for a fool this whole game? Okay, I'm hearing stuff. I want to read that, but I'm hearing stuff. Okay, I don't think it's anything. This report details the symptoms that appear when the bacterium that grows inside of the E-Series infects a human. Be sure to read this document thoroughly before dealing with the E-Series weaponized assets, hereafter referred to as the mold. Initial infection. The mold ingests nutrients from the subject's body to propagate itself and slowly takes over cells within the body. As a side effect of this, the infected subject gains remarkable regenerative abilities. During experiments, we removed arms and legs from test subjects and found that they were able to co-apt the amputated limbs in a matter of minutes. Mid-stage infection. Once the mold reaches the brain, the subject's thoughts become in tune with those of the E-Series asset. The subject starts to hear things and experience hallucinations and soon comes under the complete control of the E-Series asset. If this state continues, the host will lose all sense of ego. Complete infection. After every cell in the body has been taken over by the mold, the subject begins to lose their human form. Physical mutations differ from case to case, but all result in him or her requiring incredible physical strength. Containing a subject at this stage would be extremely difficult. So I guess those are the goopy men. Oops, I accidentally shot my gun. E-necrotoxin E-series dosage test. 5 minutes after dose, vomiting. 12 minutes after dose, cell calcification. 10 minutes after dose, death. What's in here? Target acquired. Wait, what is it looking for here? E-necrotoxin. Destroy cells of any subject based on the E-Series bioweapon model. Use only for disposal of E-Series asset. Toxin must first be stimulated before use. Do this by placing a sample of an E-Series cell into the necrotoxin container. So I need a cell sample? Oh, I have it right here. Bam. E-necrotoxin. I assume I need this to kill Evie. Project was instigated in 2000 as one of several concepts for the company's NexBus, Next Generation Experimental Battlefield Superiority Initiative. Working with the technical assistance from HCF to develop a bioweapon for neutralizing combatants en masse with minimal direct contact. NexBus was later folded and all its assets diverted to this project. What makes this project markedly different from conventional weapons is its ability to turn enemy combatants into allies, converting hostile elements into willing servants. Since this effectively eliminates the cost of not only POW handling, but also combat itself, it's no wonder we had the blank and even blank's blank organization chomping at the bit to get on board. The project would never have existed were it not for the discovery in blank of blank, the remarkably progressed vicariant evolution fungus that we commonly term the mutamycete. Fabrication method for each bioweapon has to introduce the mutamycete genome to pre-stage 4 human embryo and perform cultivation in a controlled environment over a period of 38 to 40 weeks. The resultant organisms were referred to as candidate specimens and graded based on usability, from the impractical and faulty Series A through D to the perfected E-Series. A common appearance was selected for the bioweapons, that of a roughly 10-year-old girl to ensure ease of blending in with the urban-slash-refugee populations. The first E-Series specimen, named Eveline, has proven capable of secreting the mutamycete blank from her tissue at will. It also of note that Eveline's mutamycete imposes a profound control over body and mind when introduced into a host organism. Still have a lot to learn about the mechanism by which Eveline achieves and maintains this control, but the working theory is that the vector is similar to the auto-inducer pheromones used for quorum sequencing, or sensing, in Pseudomonas bacteria. Eveline's control is exerted in a series of discrete stages, the first of which is hallucination. Almost immediately after infection, the subject begins to see images of Eveline, though she is not in fact there, and even hear her voice, which is inaudible to anyone else. Auditions with infected subjects throughout the stages of infection reveal that at first the Phantom Eveline appears to be a normal young girl, sometimes desiring companionship or assistance. As time progresses, she begins making more and more extreme demands, including self-mutilation and attacks on other people. Psychological shock this induces helps to break down the mind's natural barriers to Eveline's brainwashing effect, and by the time mental control is achieved, the mutamycete infection has progressed throughout the body's cells, so the body bleh, whatever that means. That's really interesting. So, Eveline, oh my god, more reading. Eveline's functions also include the ability to form organisms from mycelia, the fungal filaments. The term organism is used loosely here, strictly speaking. They are superorganisms formed of countless mycelia. What's important, though, is that they exhibit a strong survival instinct and will defend themselves ferociously with the slightest provocation. Their fungal toughness and remarkable strength give them significant battlefield potential. The researchers have been calling these superorganisms the molded, made of mold, and also molded as in shaped. The name has a certain elegance to it. For the treatment of accidental infections, performing blank on samples of Eveline's body tissue produces a unique fungicidal serum. Administering the serum to an infected subject will cause the mycelia to calcify, but if the subject's cells are largely invaded, the serum will be fatal. Since the treatment window is so small, the serum's primary use is therefore disposal of infected subjects rather than a cure. In exploring the serum's potential, we found that subjecting it to bleh would enhance its effects to extreme potency, becoming a compound we now call E-necrotoxin, which bleh, in even tiny amounts. What's been interesting to observe in Eveline's behavior is her obsession with the concept of family. In experiments, we found on multiple occasions that infected subjects were compelled to act as her mother or father, treating her as if she were really their daughter. Why did she settle upon family as the theme for her mental control? This is just speculation, but it could be that she instinctively understands that a family unit is better suited to blending into social groups than a lone girl. On the other hand, well, a sentimental sort might suggest that she's making up for a perceived lack of love in her quarantined upbringing, a parent's love. That is interesting. I'm not sure which one it would be, but either way, it's kind of screwed up and I don't like it. Man, this story is excellently crafted, let me just say. I am a fan of what is going on here. So, what I'm gathering here is that Eveline is grandma. She's aging a lot. And very rapidly, but maintaining in the family and still able to project herself as Eveline, either through infection. I don't know if Ethan's infected, but I guess he is. And he's hallucinating the little girl. But I'm actually running out of time for this episode, so I'm not sure how much of this game is left. I'm going to cut the episode here. If there's not enough for a full episode left when I play through and beat the game here, then I'll just edit this in and it'll be a longer episode. But thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to check out the video right down here somewhere. Yeah, right below me. And then down there. Also, here. There. Right corner somewhere. Yeah. And then subscribe in the middle if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, guys. Hello, everybody. ZombieGuts here. Welcome back to Resident Evil 7. Like I said last time, I'm pretty sure we're near the end of the game. Not sure how much is left, but I aim to finish it as quickly as I can. I've gone ahead off camera, done some crafting. You can see I have an absolutely ridiculous amount of flame rounds. I've gotten rid of my shotgun and machine guns because I didn't have much ammo for them. And I'm going to go ahead and take these psychostimulants just to make sure I get any items I can on the way through. Got 8 of these bombs. It's kind of insane. Ooh. Lots of singing. Hold on. Eveline, I know you're singing and all. And you're trying to creep me out. It's working. Just want to pick up these items, you know. More magnum ammo. That's cool. My god, that's so creepy. Please stop. Why are you mad at making me go in here? Oh my god.
Die.
I don't wanna.
Fuck.
God, let me through. Excuse me, sir. Official Ethan business. You're dead. Reload quickly. Okay, everything's cool. Reload, goopy goop. Goop it up, baby. Please get out of the way. I don't even know what I'm picking up. I'm not stopping long enough to look. That's gonna hurt a lot. Didn't want to get hit by that guy. God, getting out of here. I was able to reload in time. Oh god. Am I out of goopies? No, I'm not out of goop. Everything's cool. Everything's cool. Get me out of here. You can't cancel a reload with a goop goop, apparently. That's horrifying. Well, that used almost every resource I had. That is a much larger fatty than I've ever or had the desire to deal with. Die, please. He dead? Looks like it. Okay, he's dead. Well, that was something. Not entirely sure what, but it was something. Switch back to terrible ammo so I can get a strong first aid med. I believe I have an herb, but I can use a normal first aid. So there's that. Okay. That part's down. All it took was almost every grenade I had. Totally worthwhile. Hopefully there's not a whole lot more fighting to go. Squeeze through here. Ooh, I don't like it. Don't like it. Hey, the bullet totally went through. Mind map. And there's no box, but there's a save point. So that's good. Go ahead and save. I wish there was a storage box here. I'd switch over to some stuff that I got ammo for a second ago. It's Grandma's wheelchair. It's an Eveline doll. This is right back at the beginning of the game.
I'm sure of it.
Please, no.
It's not here. It's gone. It's gone!
That jump to flashback scared the crap out of me. Here's the staircase of horrifyingness. That's good. He didn't get me that time. Is that what Ethan looks like? Oh, hi. You're not. You are a hallucination, but you're not a flashback.
This is your fault.
Why am I seeing this?
Isn't it obvious, Ethan?
Ethan, it's okay. It's okay, it's me. I know you didn't mean to hurt me.
Kill him, Mommy.
Oh, I see.
You shouldn't have done that!
It's showing me how Eveline influenced stuff.
Fucking hurt!
Oh, please no.
Don't
not again.
Want to be my okay. Daddy? Then he can die. Now it's Mommy's turn to kill you.
No. Not Mommy's turn to kill anybody. What am I supposed to do? Oh, hi.
You're gonna be one of us. And then maybe you'll play nicely.
I'm not playing.
No! Get that away from me!
Nuh-uh.
Oh my god! Don't need your pity!
You're not real. Can I not go through this door? Guess I can't go through this door. Oh, cool. Giant Eveline doll. That's not creepy. Keep turning around to see if it's gonna be, like, looking at me.
I don't wanna hurt you.
Good God!
It
scares me every time.
Leave me.
Okay. What's happening? Please. Give me some form of coherence. I just want to know what's happening. Is he still not the right way? Maybe he wants me to go upstairs? Hey, if I had brought a lockpick, could I have jimmied that open? Nope. Well, I ain't do it. Not in this part of the game. Actually, I opened that before. Oh my god! What is going on? Please stop. I can't take it anymore. My heart.
Get away! No, you don't!
Okay. Trying to get to you.
Get away!
I'll get there eventually.
No,
get there eventually.
Get away from me! Stop! 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 No!
Gotcha! It was Grandma.
Why does everyone hate me?
That's horrifying. No way it's that simple, right? Of course not. punishment you're gonna take, G-Ma. Ow. Am I dead? Apparently I'm supposed to have. I'm shooting you. Flap, 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 flap. All I've got left is remote bombs. What do I do? Okay, please no. Don't kill me. I've already come so far.
Don't have any?
I just wanted a family.
I don't have any ammo. All I can do is hold my hands in the air and hope I don't die. I died. Okay, good thing they added a nice little manage items box here. That's good. Alright, let's see what we got here. We got lots of machine gun ammo. Remote bombs are not going to be very useful. My shotgun. I got lots of shotgun shells too, so grab that. Get rid of this handgun. Move that down there. Get this shotgun. And I think I've got burner fuel. Not a reasonable amount of burner fuel. Okay, this should. Well, actually. I don't need the burner, I don't think. That should be enough. Yeah, let's see what we can do.
You.
Yeah, everyone hates you. I get it. That animation of her like turning into just like a black humanoid form is so cool. Really well done. Okay, let's see if I can reload my weapons real quick. Lots of machine gun ammo. I don't even know if it's worth shooting her at this point. I don't know if you're supposed to or not. I'm doing it. Destroy the house. Okay. It seems that you are supposed to shoot her there. Sure, I still got my items in order. Okay. Good to know. You are supposed to shoot her there.
You.
You? Oh my god, I haven't seen this twice already. I'll show no mercy. I'll unload on her with a million guns. shooting her with a machine gun. Apparently does zero damage. Okay, there we go. Me getting slapped upside the head by a big black tentacle thing is what's supposed to happen. See, and these helicopters fly over, and they don't do anything. Shoot them with a Gatling gun or something, bruh. Oh, gotta reload, hold on, gotta put my ammunition in there. Okay, cool. Gotta sneeze.
Alright.
No, I'm impaled through the leg. I think that's supposed to happen. That or I'm just terrible at this video game. But I'm pretty sure it's supposed to happen. Why not both, right? You're terrible at the video game, and this is supposed to happen.
I just landed a bad
knee. Reload. She dropped me. He made the death sound for some reason. Scared me. I have a pistol on the ground. A crazy pistol, a fancy one. Look how fancy it is. The Albert 01. Is this Wesker's Samurai Edge? That's what it looks like.
Play time, boy.
Come on. Looks like Wesker's... Yeah, it has stars written on the side. That's awesome! That's such a cool Easter egg. It's not really even an Easter egg, but it's a cool reference. Does that mean stars is the one saving me? Look at her calcify. She gone. Rip Eveline. Please don't kill me. I've been through so much already.
I'm Redfield.
Glad Is that found. Chris?
The fuck took you guys so long?
Subtitles are very delayed.
They say that when one door closes, another opens. Well, a door closed tonight. And what a long night it was. But not just for me. Me and I weren't the only victims here. So were the Bakers. It was that thing, Eveline, who made them that way.
Umbrella.
Now Eveline's dead. And these guys are here to clean up the mess. I had just come to terms with losing Mia. But now she's back and wants to start over. Put all this behind us. Maybe this is where the next door opens.
that is an incredibly hopeful ending. And I believe, by looking at the achievements, this game does have multiple endings. I think if you give the serum to Zoe instead of Mia when you have that choice, that is where the ending changes. Oh, this is a really cool, like, interactive credit sequence. I'm just gonna skip it and see if there's anything in the end, though. And then another credit sequence. Skip that. And here we have game stats. Normal difficulty, almost 8 hours. 20 restarts, because I'm a baddie. I got half the bobblehead guys. Only 12 of the antique coins. Two steroids used, lots of healing items. Difficulty Madhouse, and weapon, the Albert O1R. That was definitely the Samurai Edge that Wesker had in the very beginning. Item, the Secrets of Defense. Additional free content, Not a Hero, coming spring 2017. I'm pretty sure that's Chris Redfield. Or someone related to him that has never been in a game before. That's so weird. It feels like they placed this in such an odd spot in the timeline. It said on the ship 16 years after the Raccoon City incident, but Chris is working for Umbrella, if that's him. And also the end credits, or the end sequence said they're here to clean up the mess, and that's awfully optimistic of Umbrella Corp. But, alright guys, that's Resident Evil 7. I'm gonna hop into the DLC, the band footage next, and then I believe they have some like little silly game modes like Jack's 55th birthday party and Ethan Must Die and that sort of thing. So I'm planning at least a couple more videos doing the extra DLC content. If more comes out, then I'll hopefully do that too. But thanks for watching, guys. You're sure to check out other videos below and subscribe if you haven't already and you enjoyed it. Thanks, guys.